My name is Ashutosh Rastogi. I am a teacher by profession. My mission is to impart quality education for all. For that purpose, I am creating these videos. If you appreciate my work, then please do like my video and subscribe my channel so that I could get the motivation to prepare more videos. Anyways, today in this particular lecture, we're going to discuss about different types of channels, in which we'll going to specifically discuss about your mutual information, what it is, and what is the physical significance of mutual information when we're going to discuss our channels. So these are the outlines. We're going to start up with the introduction. Then we're going to discuss about your discrete communication channel, what is it and how we're going to represent it. Then we're going to discuss about your mutual information. It is basically the transformation of information from source to the destination, how we will going to define it. Then we're going to discuss the various properties of mutual information, which will be followed by discussing different types of channels, such as your binary symmetric channel, lossless channel, deterministic channel, noiseless channels. We will basically going to discuss some specifications and transition metrics associated with them. So till now, we have already taken the basic knowledge of information theory, that is how to quantify the information, average information, entropy, etc. We have also gone through the various information sources, discussed over your variable length source coders, what is the need of source coding, and what are various source coding methods, such as your Huffman coding and your Shannon-Fano algorithms, we have already discussed. Now we're going to focus over the communication channel and its types. So if you closely observe that there are three basic ingredients of any communication system, that is your source, destination, or you could say a receiver, and to interconnect between your source and receiver, we'll be having a physical medium channel. So now in this particular lecture, our focus is solely over your channel. So a communication channel may be defined as the path or medium through which the symbols flow to the receiving end. So this is basically physical medium between your transmitter and the receiver, through which your information symbol will going to flow from source to the destination. So a discrete channel is characterized by an input alphabet X and output alphabet Y, and a set of conditional probabilities that would have been given as P of JK is equal to probability of YK given XJ. So here we are assuming that our source is basically going to generate different symbols, such as your X0, X1 up to X of J minus 1. And at the receiving side, we will going to receive those symbols, that is your Y0, Y1 up to Y of K minus 1. And with the help of several probabilities associated with the observation of your output symbol, when the given input symbol value is known to us, so we can characterize the properties of this channel with the help of your channel matrix, or you could say your transition matrices, which consist of several transition probabilities, such as probability of JK will be given as probability of YK given XJ, that is probability of observing YK symbol when it has been given that XJ symbol would have been transmitted. If we have the information of this transition matrices, then we are in a state to characterize our channel or physical medium. So we assume that the channel is a memoryless, that is the occurrence or generation of different symbols will not going to affect each other. So for a binary channel, where the specification is about your source will only going to generate two symbols only, that is either 0 or 1, since we are assuming your binary channel. So here our source will going to generate two symbols, that is your 0 and 1, and at the receiving side also we'll going to receive two symbols, that is either 0 and 1. And the probability associated that when we will going to transmit 0 and we'll going to receive as a 1, that is given as your P. And similarly, the error probabilities, that is when we'll going to transmit symbol 1 and we'll going to receive symbol 0, that is also equal to your P. And conversely, the probability associated with the reception of current symbol would have been given as your 1 minus P and 1 minus P. So this is the conditional probability when at the receiving side we have observed Y0 and Y1. Given that symbol transmitted was X0 and X1, that will be equal to probability 00, probability 01, probability of 10, and probability of 11. These are basically signifying that the probability, the reception of 0 symbol when 0 would have been transmitted, probability of reception of 0 symbol when 1 was transmitted, probability of reception of 1 symbol when 0 was transmitted, and probability of reception of 1 symbol when 1 was transmitted. So since these outcomes are independent to each other, so this conditional probability will simply be going to the product of all these probabilities. So if we're going to consider this particular example only, the value of this conditional probability will be equal to P square times of 1 minus P square. So now we're going to discuss a specific or a very special term, your mutual information. So if we closely observe our communication system, what is the actual goal of any communication system is to transport the information from source to the destination. So mutual information basically measures the amount of information that can be obtained about one random variable by observing another. So this is the basic significance, but here the point is we are basically representing our information sources with the help of random variable. So if we will going to incorporate that particular analogy in our communication system, then we can say that X is basically representing your information source, which will going to transmit some amount of information through channel to your destination or receiver, which would have been represented as your random variable Y. So in general, we could say that mutual information measures the amount of information that can be obtained about one random variable by observing another. That is, suppose at the receiving side, we are observing random variable Y and we need to obtain the observation related to your X. So it is important in communication where it can be used to maximize the amount of information shared between sent and the received signal, such as the case we have discussed just now, in which we have said that we will going to observe at receiver symbols Y and we will going to obtain the information associated with the symbol generated at your information side, that is your XJ. So the mutual information denoted by I of X semicolon Y of the channel would have been defined as, so this semicolon is basically representing that the mutual information that would have been exchanged from source X to Y, or in mathematical term we could say that the information that would have been transported from this random variable X to this random variable Y. So this would have been defined as your I of X semicolon Y will be equal to H of X minus H of X over Y, bits per symbol. So this is the basic definition of your information. Here important point is your unit, that is your bits per symbol. So this is your average information bits per symbol that would have been transmitted from your source to your destination. So here H of X represents the uncertainty about the channel input before the channel output is observed. So we had already discussed about the entropy and the average information, and if we have to observe the average information or uncertainty about your source X, that would have been given with your H of X, that will be equal to minus P of Xi log of Xi. This we had already discussed. In the similar fashion, H of X given Y represent the uncertainty or average information about the channel input after the channel output is observed. Whereas the mutual information I of X semicolon Y represent the uncertainty about the channel input that is resolved by the observing the channel output. So what do you mean by this particular thing? Let us understand it through your Venn diagram so that the idea of mutual information must be more clearer. So this particular figure is basically showing, this particular circle is basically showing your source X, and this particular circle is basically showing your source Y. Or you could say this is basically representing your transmitting side source and this is showing your receiving side. So the average information associated with this particular source X would have been given as your H of X, and in the similar fashion, average information associated with your Y would have been given as your H of Y. And as a whole, if we are talking about this complete system, that is the average information both contained in your X and Y, that would have been given as your H of X comma Y. So if we closely observed about this particular portion, I'm talking about this portion. So this is basically showing the portion that has been lie in your X but not in Y. Whereas this particular portion would have been telling us the portion in Y but which is not in your X. So this would have been given as your H of Y given X. So this particular portion will going to give us the information about uncertainty lie in your Y when X would have been observed, that is uncertainty in Y on observing S, whereas this H of X is basically suggesting us the information or uncertainty in your X on observing Y. So what about this particular portion? What about this particular portion is suggesting to us? So this is, if you closely observe this particular figure, this particular portion would have been given as your H of X minus H of X given Y, or you could say that is your H of Y minus H of Y given X. So what does this particular quantity is basically suggesting? So this would have been the basic definition of your information that we have already studied, that is h of x minus h of x given y, or equivalently h of y minus h of y given x. So if you closely observe that, this is basically the uncertainty in x resolved on observing y, or vice versa, that is uncertainty in y resolved on observing x. So this is the physical significance of your mutual information. So mutual information I of x semicolon y will be equal to I of y semicolon x, that is information transferred from source x to y will be equal to the information transferred from y to x. The information transferred between two random variables, or you could say sources, will always be greater than or equal to zero. Information I of x semicolon y can be given as h of y minus h of y given x. This is the basic definition that we have observed, that will also equal to your h of x minus h of x given y. Similarly, information transfer between x to y will be equal to h of x plus h of y minus h of x comma y. So this is basically the joint information that would have been combined in your x and y source as a whole. So this relationship would have been easily obtained by just putting the value of this h of y given x in this particular equation in terms of your joint entropy. So when you're looking to put it h of y given x equal to h of x and y minus h of x, so we will going to obtain this particular result. So the entropy corresponding to the mutual information, that is I of x semicolon y, indicates the measure of information transmitted through the channel, and it would have been called as your transferred information. So please keep in mind that basic phenomena that you will going to transfer some information from source x to the receiver y via some channel. So this is basically the measure, that how much amount of information you will basically going to transfer from your source towards your destination. So now we're going to discuss different types of channels available. So first one is your binary symmetric channel. We have already discussed our generalized channel and your binary channel, where in your generalized channel, we will be having multiple number of source symbols and we will going to have multiple number of received symbols. Whereas in your binary channel, we will only going to generate two symbols, and at the receiving side, we are also receiving only two symbols only. So this is the special case of your binary channel, that is your binary symmetric channel. So binary symmetric channel has your two inputs, as the name suggests. So x0, that is x0 symbol is basically having your zero value, and x1 is equal to 1. So one symbol is your 0 and another symbol is your 1, which would have been represented with your x0 and x1. And the two output variables, that is your y0 and y1, which would have been representing your 0 value and 1 value. So this channel is symmetric because the probability of receiving 1 if a 0 is sent is same as the probability of receiving a 0 if a 1 is sent. So that is, I'm talking about these probabilities. That is, you will going to transmit 0 and you will going to receive 1, and you will going to transmit 1 and you will going to receive 0. So both these probabilities are equal. That is why we are telling them as your binary symmetric channel. Whereas in your binary channel, this is not always be the case. These two probabilities might be different also. As we had already mentioned that the channel characteristics would have been easily determined with the help of your transition matrix or channel matrix. So that transition matrix would have been given as your probability of y given x will be equal to 1 minus p, p, p and 1 minus p. So what are these basically signifying? So this is basically the probability of receiving y when x would have been transmitted. So this is 1 minus p. It is basically suggesting that observing of 0 when 0 was transmitted, then this is the probability that observing 1 when 0 was transmitted. In the similar fashion, this is the probability of observing 0 when 1 was transmitted, and this is the probability of observing 1 when 1 was transmitted. So this is basically your channel matrix or transition matrix, which will be going to characterize your binary symmetric channel. So the special case of binary symmetric channel, that is BSC, is of a particular interest, that is probability of 0 1, that will be equal to probability of 1 0, that is equal to p. So here we are talking about your error probability, that is what will the probability of receiving 0 when 1 was transmitted, that is an error. And similarly, when one was transmitted and zero would have been observed, that is also an error. So these two probabilities or error probabilities will be equal to P. That is the basic criteria of your binary symmetric channel. So we are in an interest to observe this particular probability, that what it is. So the binary symmetric channel, the probability of error would have been given as probability of error will be equivalent to probability of x0 comma y1, that is the joint probability of observing x0 when y1 was transmitted, plus the probability of observing x1 when y0 was transmitted. So in both the cases we will going to obtain some sort of error. So basically error probability will be the summation of these two. From Bayes theorem we can simply expand this combined probability of x0 comma y1, that will be equal to probability of x0 into probability of y1 given x0. Similarly, by expanding this particular joint probability, we can expand with the help of Bayes theorem, such as your probability of x1 into probability of y0 given x1. So probability of y1, that given that x0 was transmitted, that is known to us, that is equal to probability of 0,1, or that will be equal to P. And the similar fashion, probability of observing y0 when x1 was transmitted, that will be equal to probability of 1,0. That is given to us, that is also equal to P. So by putting the values of this probability of 0,1 and probability of 1,0 as P, that will be equal to P times of summation of probabilities of x0 plus probability of x1. So the summation of x0 and x1, that is anyhow your information source will going to generate any sort of symbol, that will be equal to 1. So that error probability turns out to be your P. So this is how we will going to say that in your binary symmetric channel, the error probability will be equal to P only. So now we'll going to discuss another type of channel, lossless channel. So as the name suggests, that here in this particular channel, our information will not get lost. So the channel described by the channel matrix with only one non-zero element in each column is called as your lossless channel. Since we had already mentioned that channel characteristics would have been represented with the help of transition matrices. So here the important point is, each and every column there will be only one non-zero element. If this type of channel is there, or if this type of channel matrix we will going to have, the properties of that channel will be your lossless. So this is basically showing your source, and this is basically showing your receiver or reception side. So here when x1 would have been transmitted, you are receiving y1, the probability associated with your 3/4. When x1 would have been transmitted and you are receiving y2, that probability is your 1/4. Similarly, when you are going to transmit x2 and you are receiving your y3, that probability is your 1/3. And when you are going to transmit your x3 and you are receiving your y4, that is equal to 1. So this particular scenario would have been described with this particular channel matrix. So this is the characterization of your lossless channel. So next one is your deterministic channel. So here with the help of your transition matrix, we are in a state to determine the characteristics of your channel, or we will going to obtain various information about your channel, such as how much attenuation will going to take place in the channel, we can obtain or determine. So a channel described by the channel matrix with only one non-zero element in each row is called the deterministic channel. So please keep in mind, here the keyword is your each row, whereas in your lossless channel we are talking about your each column, but here we are talking about your each row. So if we closely observe this transition matrices, that is 100, 100, 010, 001. So if you are observing about these rows, each and every row will going to have one non-zero element. So this is the basic criteria of your deterministic channel. Rest of the things will going to remain same. Here x1, x2, x3 and x4 are your generated symbols at the transmitting side or source side, and y1, y2, y3 are your receiving symbol at your receiving side. So next one is your noiseless channel. So as the name suggests, there will be no noise in the channel. So channel is called noiseless if it is both lossless as well as the deterministic. So if we're going to follow both these properties of your lossless as well as deterministic, then that channel would have been called as your noiseless channel. So for a noiseless channel, here the important point is your rows should be equal to your column, or we should talk about your square matrix only. So that is, specifically you could say that number of symbols generated at your source side will be equal to number of symbols received at your receiver side, or in the first figure that we have discussed about your channel, in that particular case your J will be equal to K. So here the transition matrix would have been given as your probability of y given x, that will be equal to 100 010 001. So if you closely observe that, here in each row we will going to have one non-zero element, and each column we will going to have your one non-zero element. That is why we are calling them as your noiseless channel. So as we have discussed that here, we will be having three number of information symbols and three number of observed symbols. So the probability associated with them, that is equal to unity as per this particular channel matrix or transition matrix. So this is basically representing your noiseless channel. So hopefully you guys have get the idea about the mutual information, its physical significance, as well as different types of channels. So in case of any doubt, you can ask me in the comment section. I'll try to solve them out as soon as possible. So these are the references. Thank you very much for your patient hearing.